Hello fabulous DIYers, it's Diana Tabois here, and in this video I'm going to fit the bra cup bodice that I draped in my last tutorial on a live model. For my fabulous model of the hour is my mother. She is a size 16/18 sometimes, and I'm going to fit her, and I'm going to fit the bodice without boning just to see the initial fit. She's wearing her bra, so let's chime in on the fit session.
But how does a cup feel?
Where in that city?
Wait, let me see. This. No, I tightened this one up. Did you see that? Mm-hmm. Okay. Can you hold the waist? No, you don't have to hold the back, but.
Where you want me to hold it?
You can hold it like right here on the side.
Like that?
Yeah. Hold it like that. Let me see. Yeah, because you need this to be.
But this is not sitting on, and this is looking.
Yeah, I have to. That's why I have to. You see, I closed it here. You see that? Mhm. This is loose, because it needs to be like that. Mhm. And then your side. Turn to the back, because I just want to show the people. You see? It's too small. It's like you need 2 inches, maybe 3. One inch. Yeah, 2.5. Maybe 2 inches. To close it. Make it fit. Because I have to put the thing in there. Alright, turn around. Oh gosh.
So we continued the fit session and discussed the changes that I was going to make, such as making the bodice and bra cup bigger. So as you remembered, in the bra cup, I had taken it in just a little bit with a small dart. I took that apart from the bodice and pressed it out so I can get the full fit and shape of that portion, and traced it onto pattern paper. Now here you can see that I basically put in the 1/2 inch seam allowance, and this is my new pattern. This pattern, I'm going to go and separate it in half because I wanted to make the bra cup bigger by 1/2 inch. So what I did was slit it down the middle where it meets at the bottom portion of the bra cups of the pattern pieces, and then taped it to some pattern paper to make it bigger. So here's the pattern piece.
So these are the patterns here, and what I'm going to do is add 1/4 inch to all the seams, side seam, princess seams, back seam. Instead of the center back, I'm going to add an additional 1/4 to the center front. Here I have a fold line 1/2 inch just in case I wanted to do a 1/2 inch seam allowance, but I'm going to just take that away and add 1/4 inch instead and put against the fold, so that will be bigger in the front. And then I'm going to add 1/4 inch on the bust cup at the bottom just to make this bigger, so it will be like 1/2 inch in every seam, and that's going to make the cup much bigger. So I'm hoping that these changes are going to make the bodice bigger. And then we're going to go and make these adjustments on new paper, so that size is going to be graded up to the next size. And then we're going to put everything together, and then I'm going to refit again.
So here is the pattern pieces. I'm basically tracing it to prepare them to add the 1/4 inch, as I said before, to all the pattern pieces. So here are the patterns completed. I went up a size, but depending on the fit, I'm going to decide if this is an 18 or a 16, but that's up to me. So here I am cutting them out on muslin again to prepare them to put them together. And as you can see, the center front is cut on the fold. It has no longer has a seam allowance at the front anymore. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put the bra cups together first. I'm going to work with that. I'm gonna work with that portion first. So here is neoprene. Now for the bra cups, if you're gonna create a bra cup like this, you would need some foaming pad. I don't have any foaming pad, so what I had was neoprene, and this was kind of thick just as the foaming pad. So I'm gonna use that as a substitution. So what you have to do for this part is that you have to cut off the seam allowance about 1/2 inch on the inside of the bra cup and on the top portion of the bra cup, as well as the bottom portion of the top portion of the bra cup and at the top. You need to cut off 1/2 inch seam allowance so that way you are connecting the bra cup padding together. So here I'm just gonna take my scissors just to demonstrate that I'm cutting it off, but I basically had to do this for all pattern pieces, and I could have made a pattern separate with the 1/2 inch already removed, but I was being lazy, so I'm gonna do this on the actual fabric itself. So my neoprene is kind of perforated. That's the one I had. I'm gonna just use the perforated side against the fabric so that way you don't see it on the inside. So I'm simply cutting the 1/2 inch away where I need to remove it, and I'm going to go ahead now and connect it with a zigzag stitch in the sewing machine. So we're going to start with the bottom pieces of the bra cup. So here we are at the machine. I'm going to do a wide stitch so I can make sure I'm able to stitch both sides and get them connected, and I'm going to go and take my time just to apply this stitch down the center of the bra cups. So this is what it looks like on the inside. This is where I want on the inside. This is the outside of the bra cup. And usually you're supposed to take a bias binding or some type of binding to cover the zigzag stitch, because it's not as cute if you nicely bind it. So I'm not going to do that because this is just a model and we're just going to be testing the fit. So I'm going to repeat the same process with the top portion of the bra cup and doing that zigzag stitch to connect it. And this is what it looks like. And again, you can see the zigzag stitch, but this is going to be covered with the outer layer of fabric. So here is the bra cup that I prepared with my muslin, and that's going to be laid right on top of the bra cup, and I'm wanting to cover the perforated part of my neoprene. So as you can see that the top of the neoprene, of the bra cup padding is 1/2 inch cut off. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to sew 1/4 inch of the self fabric connected to the top portion of the bra cup padding. So here it is connected with 1/4 inch seam allowance, and I'm going to flip that over onto the right side of the bra cup, and I'm going to pin that down so that way it stays down and neat when it's time for me to sew. So the right side of the bra cup is showing, and here's the inside. And once again, if I covered it with binding, it would look cute, but I'm not gonna do that for this time for fitting purposes. So I'm gonna pin that outer layer to the padding to make sure it stays, and this is what it looks like. And I'm gonna repeat the same process for the other side of the bra cup. Now that's done, I'm going to connect the bottom portion of my bodice and sew it 1/2 inch. So here it is sewn 1/2 inch. Now what I'm going to do is top stitch it about 3/8 inch so that way I can create a casing for my boning. So I'm going to do that for all seams. So here I am at the machine. I'm basically showing you that I'm going to take it to sew down 3/8 inch a top stitching so I can create my boning casing. Now that's complete. Now it's time for me to install the bra cups. And at the center of the bra cup seam, I'm going to match it up at the princess seam as well and pin that into place. Now you're going to notice that the top edge of my bodice has 1/2 inch seam allowance, and that's because I already took it away from the bra cup, which made it smaller, and that top edge will be turned inside when it's time for me to turn the top edge of the seam allowance inside the bodice. So here you can see the 1/2 inch extension at the edge of the bra cup. and I'm going to pin that into place. So here it is all pinned in place, and I'm going to sew a half an inch seam allowance to seal that in place. So here it is sewn down, and what I'm going to do is cut down a quarter of an inch seam allowance. So here I remove that excess, and now I'm going to take some bias binding and just bind that to create my casing for the underwire. So what I'm going to do is stitch that binding onto the seam allowance. So here it is up close, and then I'm going to go ahead and stitch the other edge of the binding onto the bodice at the edge all the way around. So here it is completely and done. It looks good already. And here is the underwire. This was the biggest I could find, which is 6 inches wide. And I'm going to go ahead and install that and insert it in the casing so that it can create some structure to the bra cup. So here it is. And it gives it more shape and body to the bodice. And I'm going to repeat the same process on the other side. So here it is fully completed. And I'm going to, that top edge where it was a half an inch, I'm just going to fold it down and just top stitch it down into place. On the actual garment, I'm going to finish it differently. But for now, since I'm just going to be fitting, I'm just going to fold that down. Same as the center front of the bodice as well. And then I'm going to insert the boning afterwards. So here's my boning. I'm just going to pre-measure. I use this plastic boning for all my fashion pieces. I don't use the wire one because I kind of think it's for costumes. I haven't experimented with that yet. I just stick with the plastic. And what I'm going to do is curve the edges to make it more round. And this is what it looks like up close. So that way it won't rub against the fabric and fray the fabric. So I'm going to insert that because I'm going to be using this boning for later in the actual real garment. And this is what it looks like inserted. So I'm going to try this on for our next second fish section. So let's chime in.
Yeah, put in more. We put in more, maybe the more tight.
Should I put a zipper? Turn to the side so I can show the people what I'm doing. And step back, mother. Step back. Step to the yes. Okay. Yeah, so you need a strap. Let me see on this side now. Let me close this side. Lift your arm up.
But we're not finished what we're doing video.
This is for fitting.
Yeah, because this is not sitting. This is sitting.
This is need one here. This need a stick here.
So how do you look?
I mean, okay, let's see. Let me show you.
Yeah, this is out.
Let me show you the mirror. Because... You see?
Oh, you don't look bad. But when I'm looking at my boss, when you look at the mirror, he look like it's fine there.
You see it in the mirror?
Yes, I see it now.
But your breast is, you know, I don't know if you want to put a bra on to see the difference, but you see the shape, right? I think the front needs one stick. You see the back? Turn to the back.
Okay.
But the side is just... So, I need to add a boning right here in the middle, a boning channel, which I completely forgot. And then this is the side. And this is the side where it was tightened. So, it's about a half an inch off on each side, which I'm going to remove. to bring it right back in together. So I'm going to take this apart, press it out, and then shape it to remove that half an inch, and then that should tighten this up in this area. I'm going to put a boning right here, and I'm also going to put a boning right in here to really pick that up, and we'll see how the fit is once again.
So now I'm just going to go ahead and make those alterations. My patterns already have seam allowance, so I'm not removing any seam allowance. All I got to do is just remove the portion of the amount that I'm going to reshape and fit again. So I'm using my hip curve ruler and just reshaping it back to the outer edge of the bodice. And then once I've completed that, I'm going to cut that off and then repeat that for the front portion of the bodice and then connect it again. And to repeat the whole process as I did in the beginning. So I'm going to go ahead and insert that boning.
Okay, so I just finished sewing everything and making my corrections. I added the boning, an additional boning channel right here on the side. So this is the inside of it. So I just added some bias binding and just basically stitched it down, add the boning in there. So the center has one now, along with the sides, and then I added a zipper to be easier for me to fit her now. So we're going to try it again and see how the fit is. Ooh, I'm excited. Okay, so now this is the, with the bra. Let me zip you up.
This black pants is more better than the other one.
I didn't see nothing wrong with the other one.
You want me to put the other one?
No. Ooh, it's fitting nice so far. You don't think so?
Mm-hmm.
Wow! This looking really good. You don't think so?
Mm-hmm. You tell me, oh, it's not.
Okay, so turn around to the back. So I added the zipper to really, like, you know, secure it.
You see, that pants, because the other one made my stomach more blow on the top here.
Oh, makes you more flatter here.
Yeah, this one, you know.
This is with the bra on. Do you like it with the bra on?
Of course, it'd be more popping, more thing. What do you think, no?
It looks good.
With the bra on.
Okay, you want to try it without the bra? This fits really good now.
Why you want to try without no bra?
Because I want to see if,
You want me to take off the bra now?
Yeah, let's take off the bra and see what it looks like.
Yeah, well, people who don't wear no bra, like you said.
Now, what do you feel?
Tell me how you look.
How do you think it looks? I mean, I feel like it needs some more support. Like, it needs to be like...
Yeah, to hold the thing up, you know?
Yeah, it's a little...
Yeah, because you make a thing...
You fix here? Because this is... Your thing is hanging.
It squeeze that, you know, you have to put one on the middle here.
One in the middle here, right?
Uh-huh. You put, because the way they put it, they have to put it in the clothes and then the thing come and squeeze you more.
Oh, I see.
To give you more shape.
But do you think it needs to be tighter? Or no?
I think it's Okay, like when you put the thing, the bunny inside, it's not gonna, if it tells, it's not gonna be too, I don't know. Yeah, it looks like you have room there.
You still have space.
See?
I mean, I could take it a little bit more. But so far, it looks good. So,
I'm gonna take out, it's not the bunny you're gonna put?
No, I'm gonna no more. I'm finished. This is the last fit. Whatever I design now, I can design it to make it smaller.
So we continue the fit session discussing how else I can make the bodice much better. If you enjoyed this tutorial, let me know down in the comments your thoughts on the fit session. Or if you liked the video, you can give it a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed, go ahead and subscribe for more videos like this. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye, guys.